hope it doesn't make you uncomfortable being here after what I put you through.
No, not at all. That's ancient history. So, what's up?
I've been seeing a therapist, trying to figure out why I stayed with Kiefer even after he started hitting me.
Good. And what have you come up with?
Let's sit. The therapist said it might be linked to my relationship with my dad, and I think she might be right. Kiefer and my dad were a lot alike. Kiefer was always in charge, and he'd get mad and then apologize and say how much he cared about me and loved me, and they made me feel special, and that's how it was with my dad.
Well, it sounds like you're making progress.
I invited my dad to a therapy session today.
That's a bold move.
No kidding. It's like we were speaking two different languages. And finally, he just got up and announced we were leaving, and that was that.
Well, it was brave of you to try.
I don't feel brave at all. When I think of what a doormat I was with Kiefer, it makes me feel so pathetic.
Oh, Christina, the last thing you are is pathetic, okay? You're a survivor, and I admire that.
Might sound kind of weird, but I'm glad I chose you to get a crush on.
Really? And why is that?
Well, you told me to have respect for myself and not to put up with anything less. And somewhere inside, I wanted that, and you're a good guy. So even though I messed things up and I was way too young for you, liking you was a positive step for me.